Hey guys, welcome to today's video. So I'm going to be talking about my tretinoin journey today. And this was actually requested from one of my subscribers, and somebody asked if I could film my tretinoin experience and share my journey and talk about how long it took for my skin to be accustomed to tretinoin. Did I experience purging along the way, etc.? And I thought that this would make a really great video, as I've talked a lot about tretinoin on my channel, but I've never really sat down and shared my experience with all of you. And if you're thinking about going on tretinoin or you're just starting out, maybe my journey and my story can help you, because I feel like with tretinoin, everybody tolerates to this product so differently. A lot of people will experience the dryness and the irritation along the way, and then there are a lot of people that will not experience that. So tretinoin can be a difficult product to use, but if you are patient and you're consistent, this product really is amazing. And I am so happy that I have introduced tretinoin into my skincare routine. It really has made a world of a difference, and it's one of my favorite products that I like to use on an everyday basis. So if you're curious to hear my story on tretinoin, then please keep on watching. All right, so let's talk about my tretinoin journey. Now, if you are new to a retinol or a retinaldehyde or a prescription tretinoin, and you really don't know the difference between the three, I did upload a video not too long ago talking about the three and how different they are from one another. So I will leave that video below for you in the description box, as well as up here if you would like to watch that video after this video. So tretinoin, this is a retinoid, this is retinoic acid, and this is considered a medication in most countries, and this is prescribed by your dermatologist or your family doctor. Now, there are countries around the world where this is considered an over-the-counter product, but in most countries, it is considered a medication, especially here in Canada. So I started my tretinoin journey fall of 2019, so I've been on it almost 2 years this coming fall. Now, the reason why I started tretinoin in the first place was because I was experiencing a lot of breakouts, and I also had hyperpigmentation. I still have hyperpigmentation in this area from post-acne marks. I also have freckles all over, but I do have freckles in this area that are in clusters, so they appear to be more prominent in my cheek area, and I do have some redness also. So tretinoin can be used for so many skin concerns, and that was my skin concern at the time. And of course, I wanted something for prevention for fine lines and wrinkles as well. So my dermatologist prescribed me the Steva A brand, and this is the tretinoin cream at a 0.025% strength. This is the lowest strength, and there are two higher strengths from this one. So I've been on this brand and this percent since day one. Now, when I first started using tretinoin fall of 2019, I started using this 1 day a week, and I was using tretinoin 1 day a week for several weeks to a couple of months. My skin was so dry and irritated from this product that I couldn't imagine using the product any more than what I was using. And of course, when you get the prescription from your local pharmacy, they tell you you can use this every day and make sure you wear sunscreen. But honestly, listen to your skin, start slow and work your way up. Test the waters, see how your skin is going to react, because like I said, everybody reacts to tretinoin so differently, and I was at 1 night a week for a couple of months. So eventually I made my way to 2 nights a week, and I left several days in between. So let's say I was using tretinoin on a Monday, I would use tretinoin again on the Thursday, and I would leave several days in between. And I was at 2 nights a week for several months. Then eventually I went to 3 days a week, and so on. So now I'm at 5 to 6 days a week. I usually use tretinoin 6 days a week, but depending on what my skin is like, how dry it is, or what other types of products I would like to use that week, that will usually determine whether I am using tretinoin 5 or 6 days a week. And I still experience dryness and irritation to this day, but of course it's not to the extent that I was experiencing from day one. So my skin can sometimes feel tight still. I will get flaky around my mouth area, and sometimes my makeup won't always look lovely because of the dryness, but it is something that is quite normal when using tretinoin, and I can see why people get discouraged once they start seeing all of that dryness and irritation. They give up and they stop using it. But remember, skincare is a journey. Skincare takes time to work, and if you can be patient and stick with it and just deal with the dryness and irritation at the beginning, I'm telling you right now, once your skin becomes accustomed to it, you will be golden after that. You will start noticing nice results with your skin. And once your skin becomes accustomed to tretinoin completely, you won't experience the dryness and irritation like you're experiencing now. So again, if you can be patient, tretinoin is amazing. Now, did I experience purging along the way? Yes, I did. Now, it wasn't a lot of purging, but I remember when I first started, I had a lot of breakouts on my cheeks, areas where my pores were a little bit more prominent. Of course, my pores were obviously clogged, so tretinoin or any type of active ingredient like glycolic or even lactic or salicylic acid, these types of active products can cause purging. So it's cleaning out your pores, it's getting rid of all of that gunk and debris, and it's trying to clear your skin. So yes, I did experience purging, but it wasn't terrible. Now there's different ways that you can use tretinoin. You can apply it after your serums and then of course your moisturizer on top. If your skin is more sensitive and on the drier side, you can actually apply moisturizer before your tretinoin and do the sandwich technique. So you'll have moisturizer, tretinoin, and then moisturizer again. And then of course, you can mix your tretinoin with your moisturizer and apply it to your skin. It really is a personal preference. It just depends on how dry and sensitive your skin is and how you would like to apply the tretinoin. But from day one, my dermatologist told me to use my tretinoin with the Obagi Nu-Derm Blend Effects. This is a blending cream. This helps to spread the tretinoin evenly across your skin. It's very hard to use tretinoin by itself because all you need is a pea-sized amount. And as you know, using a pea-sized amount, it's really hard to spread a product evenly across the skin. So he told me to mix a pea-sized amount of my tretinoin with a pea-sized amount of the Blend Effects. So this is a blending cream, but it's also a brightening product as well, as there is arbutin in here. And I'm really glad that he told me to do this technique because this is helping to fade my hyperpigmentation at the same time as the tretinoin cream. Now this isn't necessary to have with tretinoin, but this is what I like doing, and I've been doing this since day one, and I really like this. I like the way that this pairs together and how it spreads across the skin. So I do have a video on my channel applying the two together on my skin. It was my nighttime routine. I will leave that below. But you can just mix your tretinoin cream, like I said, with a moisturizer, or do the sandwich technique, or apply your tretinoin on top of your serums and then moisturizer. So there are so many ways. So there were some products from day one that have helped me along the way with dryness and irritation. And the first product is one that I've talked about a ton on my channel, especially if you've been following me for quite some time. And I was using the First Aid Beauty Ultra Repair Cream, and this is for dry, parched skin, great for sensitive skin as well. This has oatmeal in it as well as shea butter, very calming and soothing ingredients, and this is also very hydrating as well. So what I would do is, once I've applied my Obagi product with my tretinoin, I would apply this on top to give my skin more hydration and to help prevent dryness and irritation that can occur a few days later. And this really helped, and I really like this. And I still use this to this day, but there is another product that I enjoy better that I believe works a little bit better in my opinion, which I will share in just a minute, but I've been using this since day one. So I highly recommend if you haven't already tried this. The other product that I was using is the CeraVe Healing Ointment. And the way that I would use this is that I would prep certain areas on my face prior to applying tretinoin. You can sometimes experience cracking in certain areas on your face if you get the product too close to that area. And those areas are where your earlobe meets your jawline, the corners of your mouth, and the corners of your eyes, and sometimes even around your nose area. So if you get tretinoin too close to these areas, they can crack and they can bleed, and it's very uncomfortable, and I've experienced that so many times along the way. So I've started applying the CeraVe healing ointment to those areas prior to applying tretinoin to help create a barrier so that once I apply tretinoin on top, it won't penetrate to those areas. So this has been a game changer for that purpose, and I like to slather my lips with this also, because if you get tretinoin too close to your lips will become very dry and irritated. And I've been there many times. I actually just had that experience a couple of weeks ago. I got too carried away, I guess, and I got too close to my mouth, and my lips were so dry and irritated, and they're still a little bit dry. They're still a little bit flaky. It's taken 2 weeks for my lips to go back to normal. So I highly recommend picking up a product like this or the Vaseline or Aquaphor and prepping your lips before applying tretinoin, because I'm telling you right now, this will be your best friend. It really will be. And when I would experience a lot of irritation, I mean a lot of irritation, or my skin is stinging and it feels tight, I would go in with the Eucerin Calming Cream. Now this is a body cream, but I use this on my face when my face is very irritated. And I actually did a video on this where I shared my experience with irritation on my neck caused by retinol. I shared a before and after photo, and this was the product that healed my neck. I will leave that video below for you in case you haven't seen that, but this you can just find at your local drugstore. This has oatmeal in it, so it's that calming and soothing ingredient, and this has just been a lifesaver to repair damaged skin. Amazing. So definitely pick this up just to have on hand just in case. You can use this all over your body, of course, but I was using this on my face as well as my neck, and I still do, and it's amazing. So the cream that I'm using instead of the First Aid Beauty Ultra Repair Cream is the Pharmacy Honey Halo Ultra Hydrating Ceramide Moisturizer. So this has ceramides in it to help repair your skin barrier. There's buckwheat honey, royal jelly, propolis, which are very calming and soothing ingredients, and this is very hydrating. So I feel like this moisturizer really does outperform the First Aid Beauty Ultra Repair Cream in my opinion, and this has been my go-to to apply on top of tretinoin, and I use this almost every single night. So I really like this. This is another great option, of course. Another option that is affordable that I tend to do quite a bit is to use the CeraVe Moisturizing Cream. This also has ceramides in it as well as hyaluronic acid, and this is also very gentle and another great option. So you can use this. Another cream that I've just started to incorporate, especially when my skin is a little bit irritated, is the La Roche-Posay Cicaplast Balm B5. And this is also another fabulous cream to apply to help calm your skin. So there are so many options out there. These are ones that really worked for me, but as long as you're using a gentle hydrating moisturizer, that should be good enough, especially if you're somebody that really doesn't experience irritation or even dryness. It's just a great product to have just to balance out your skin and to keep it as hydrated as possible. You want to make sure that you're wearing sunscreen when you're using tretinoin as well. You should be wearing sunscreen regardless, but especially when you're using tretinoin, because this can make your skin a little bit more sensitive to the sun. And we're using tretinoin for a reason. We're trying to help fade and lighten hyperpigmentation. We're trying to reverse signs of aging. And if you're not going to use sunscreen hand in hand with your tretinoin, then there's no point of using tretinoin, because you're not going to see the results that you want to see. The sun is going to make your hyperpigmentation more prominent, and of course you're going to see more signs of aging. So make sure that you're using sunscreen every single day. So this is my journey with tretinoin. I haven't been on it too long, but 2 years is long enough, and I've really enjoyed it. This is one of my favorite products that I like to incorporate in my skincare routine because I have seen amazing results with it so far, and I can only imagine what other types of results that I'm going to see with long-term use. It has really improved my skin. So if you're thinking about going on Tretinoin, I highly recommend. And if you're on it and you're struggling, hang in there. Keep going, be patient, use products to keep your skin as hydrated as possible. You will get through it and you will start to see beautiful results with your skin, especially if you are consistent. So thank you so much for watching. I really do appreciate it. I would love to hear your Tretinoin story. Leave your comments below. Let me know how long it took you to get accustomed to the product. How long have you been on it? Have you seen results? I would love to hear your feedback. So I will definitely see you all in my next video. Take care, and I will see you guys then. Bye, guys.